हेलो, मैं हूँ श्रुति विद माय सेकंड नेचर एंड टुडे विद मी इज डॉक्टर रचना पाटनी. हेलो डॉक्टर, हाउ आर यू?
हेलो श्रुति, आई एम वेरी वेल, थैंक यू.
यू नो, फेब्रुअरी आते ही सबको ऐसे सडनली लिटिल अटैक स्टार्ट हैपनिंग. ओ एम आई लोनली, ओ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, ओ ऑल दीज प्लान्स फॉर द मंथ ऑफ लव. सो हाउ इज योर लव मंथ गोइंग?
Well, actually, just last month, there was the International Film Festival in Goa. And I wrote an article on how Valentine's Day and the month of love can be such a torturous journey for so many people. Very aware of, the different ways in which people experience this month.
Yes. So, which is why I thought that instead of making it a month of love, let's change it a bit and make it a month of self-love. Because you know, you could just guide us through it and help us with how do we fall in love with ourselves if we're not already, and how should we be in a healthy relationship with ourselves? Because we normally get to hear that a lot. If you want to be in a good relationship, in a healthy relationship with your partner, first learn to be in love with yourself. But what if I'm not? How do I go about it? So first, let's just level the ground, level the playing field, and cover the basics. What is self-love?
So self-love, actually, it's a relationship-based concept. When we don't have the experience of receiving love unconditionally, then we may begin to place conditions even in loving ourselves. So self-love really is learned first in a relationship which is unconditionally accepting and loving of you. एक concept के बारे में बहुत बात करती हूँ, which is about how are we received in the world. So it's that reception, wedding ke baad reception hota hai na, waise hi at birth there's how are we treated at reception, how are our needs met, that sets very often the tonality for how we meet our own needs and how we receive ourselves. That answers your question.
It's kind of answering, but I'm going to dig deeper as I start asking you more questions about it. You're so right when you're saying that we first need to figure out how we are received. But then the question is, how are we receiving ourselves? And that then goes into what are the filters jo bachpan se humne khud pe dale hain, conditions jo humne apne, what we think that we should be, and then uske basis pe aap kaise accepted the. So, there's another thing that we get to hear about, which is, how selfish are you? That if you're only bothered about yourself, if you're only bothered about khud ke needs, khud ki wants, then you're being very selfish. How selfish is being in self-love?
So I want to hold the ideas that I have mentioned already. They are very crucial and I want to open like that. That self-love is something to develop in a relationship. We can develop self-love in a relationship when we are young. If it has come very easily to us, that's great. But we can always develop self-love in a relationship with ourselves. Whenever in life we become open and aware to this possibility. Hold that as an important starting point. I'll move on to this notion ki self-love is a selfish thing. And actually that couldn't be further from the truth. Many times people confuse selfish with self-love. And I often use the phrase self-full rather than selfish. So, which is different from being full of yourself. When we say you're full of yourself, that basically means that the person has no capacity and capability for a relationship where there's space for another. But being in a relationship of self-love means that you are actually able to hold space for another. Because first you're able to hold space for yourself. Being able to be yourself is the first ingredient in being in any other relationship. So when we are devoid of self-love, jab self-love hamare practice mein nahi hai, then we cannot truly love anybody else. That is not love, but that is we are pretending certain things to be in a relationship. So you're constantly having to second guess ki mujhe abhi kaise karna chahiye taki I can keep this relationship. So you're in this thing of, what is the performance I have to do to have this relationship going, because I need this relationship to go. But when you're in a place of self-love, then you're authentically in a relationship. Then you're not thinking, if I text this, what does it mean to that person? You know,
reaction kaisa aayega, you know, kya hoga?
What is the strategy? What is the tact that's going to keep the relationship? You get away from all that. Truth of being yourself. So, with self-love, you are authentic in a relationship. And that is the best gift you can give anybody else. So, how is that selfish? It's quite the opposite of that.
So, how do we do that then? Like, how do we not play games, not get into all that? And how should we develop that self-love within us?
So, you know, what I find in India specifically, but also everywhere where I've worked, and I've worked in several different countries and contexts, is that we often think ki, you know, kuch bhi dukh huye bina hum bilkul theek ho jaye. Matlab, kuch bhi hume, achha, agar hume bola jaye ki, you know, think about your childhood, did you feel acceptance? We're like, let's not go there. Why can't we just start now? You know, I mean, why? Because, I mean, it's done in different ways. People will say,
yeah, why do you have to live in the past? People say like that also.
I don't want to live in the past. Oh, why should I blame my parents? Or, you know, oh, come on, everyone has their limitations. Or other people have had much worse childhoods than mine. You know, there are like so many creative ways of not being honest with ourselves. And, you know, it's all part of how we keep going. So I'm not at all dismissing it or making fun of it. But I'm putting it out here so that we can all see the different ways in which we do it.
हाँ, कॉन्टेक्स्ट जरूरी होता है. कॉन्टेक्स्ट मिलेगा तभी वील बी एबल टू से अच्छा जब हम ये कर रहे थे या ये करते हैं या कोई और करता है. हाउ वी कैन फिक्स इट विद इन आवरसेल्व्स.
सो व्हेन पीपल व्हेन आई वर्क विद एनीबॉडी एंड आई स्टार्ट टू गेट देम टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन हाउ इज सेल्फ लव क्रिएटेड, इट इज क्रिएटेड इन योर प्राइमरी रिलेशनशिप्स. एंड एक्चुअली द आइडिया इज टू मूव बियॉन्ड ब्लेम. बट in order to move beyond blame, you need to first be open to the truth of your experience.
So primary relationships, you mean like parents? Primary relationships would be those only, na?
Maybe caregivers. In extended homes, there might be more than just parents. But, you know, very often, first is the mother. And then are the other carers. There's also, you know, there are people who are born outside of a relationship with the mother, like, you know, where they've had to navigate life in a very different set of circumstances. But whatever, even the absent mother is a relationship.
Right, right.
So the first thing is to start to say, right, every time I feel that I'm not going to, I don't need to go there, you know, I can do this without being there. Then let's hold it. And let's say, maybe I can do it, but why am I so scared of going there? Why do I need this to be kept wrapped up? What am I scared of? So often what happens is, we are scared of our own unresolved anger towards things that have happened to us in our childhood. But we are not aware that we are scared of our unresolved anger. We are not even aware we have unresolved anger. Because ye sab toh, you know, we have dug it deep inside and we have not done it consciously. So hume kyun pata rehta? Actually pata agar rehta toh hum ye kyun karte? But we are all human and we all do these things. You know, so that's why there's a shared universe where we can learn ki haan ye sab karte hain, so we can make it okay for ourselves. So that's my commitment, that, you know, it's okay to say that childhood wasn't perfect.
And I think at that point to accept self and say it's okay. It's okay. And then show that love to self and accept oneself so that one can move past it, right?
Yeah, but you know, the opening up ki what all was not okay, it is like opening Pandora's box.
Yes.
So nobody wants to do it. Kyunki hume in worms ko dekhna hai. Matlab, hum kyun na usko band rakhe and we can build up life. So that's what happens. We end up having to pretend a lot because we don't have the courage to look at our worms. And actually, you know, the more you look at them, the more you can be friendly with them. Because wo kitne squirmy wormy hote hain, you know, they are not like some horrible creatures who are going to like come and attack you. The more you get to know worms, you may even feel love for your unmet needs. You may feel love for all the things that were not perfect. So why not allow that capacity to love that Pandora's box that we all have? So, you know, I advocate for this kind of approach of honesty. And honesty not just from your head. Because, you know, when I start working with people, they say, "Ye sab to mujhe pata hai." You know, yeah, I know all this. But I know this is different from what are you feeling about what happened. And it's that movement from knowing to feeling that you can actually start to forgive, you can actually start to let go, and then you can be in a relationship of self-love where you see things and you have that capacity to stand by your own side.
So now that we have opened this Pandora's box and now we're getting deeper into, okay, we're going to talk about self-love this month. This first episode, what is that one exercise that if you were to give us so that we can actually benefit and learn to love self? Because, you know, now I know that I already want to tell you and our listeners that the one thing we're going to discuss in the next episode is loneliness. Because, you know, jaise ye pyar mohabbat ki baat hoti hai, sabse pehle baat aati hai, oh, but I'm very lonely, I need somebody. Or why am I not finding somebody, why am I so lonely? So ye jo loneliness ka ek bahut bada taboo lag jata hai na, we're going to discuss that in the next episode. So today, what is that one piece of advice, but via an exercise that you want us to do, that can help us?
So one exercise that you know, I have probably read a long time ago. I'm not sure I read it exactly like this because I always, you know, add something of my own in the moment. What really helps is, let's say you imagine you kind of take some time, sit in a quiet space. Maybe you want to light a candle or something, like create a space for yourself where you're going into a reflective atmosphere for yourself. And then you allow your mind to wander to the first memory you have of yourself. And then you see, what are you feeling over there? You know? And maybe write it down. You may even want to kind of look at a mirror as you do this, if it helps you. So you can go back to your first memory with your mother, let's say. Okay. So you could start, like, say, I'm assuming, you know, you're 25 to 30 years old or beyond, but you can start with a memory with your mother at age 30, then go to 25, then go to 20, then go to 15, then go to 10, then go to 5, and then go to earliest. And just write the different moments that come up for you and what are you feeling. Then just notice, is there a theme? Okay, and allow yourself to be brave enough to see the themes. See whether your needs were met, and if they were not met, the first thing will be to justify what all was happening in your mother's life, why she couldn't do it, you know, she was herself, blah 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 blah. However, all that is the adult mind talking. Okay, all that is adult rational mind justifying. But we are trying to get to what was the child's experience, because that is what has been left unprocessed in our bodies. Okay, so we want to say, it's okay, we recognize that, you know, mothers are also overworked, we don't want to like do any further damage to what all women in India may have to go through when they are birthing their children and all that. With all of that, you want to be truthful about the child's experience. So what was I experiencing when, let's say, when my mother, you know, I was hungry, but then my brother needed something else and the brother got it first. I'm making all this up, okay? This is not from my life. These are things that happen in our lives, okay? So whatever it is, whichever things come up for you, just write them. And then you can say to yourself, at this moment when I was 5 years old, I needed my mother to see me. And then you can say, I'm going to see myself. So what am I doing in this exercise? I am encouraging you to be truthful about knowing which of your need was not met. And I'm inviting you to be resourceful, because that need was not met. You could not meet your own need when you were 5 years old. But now that you're 30 or 35 or 40, maybe you can meet your need. So it's like, I want to go back to that moment and give myself something that I couldn't give myself then. And in doing that, I forgive whoever needs forgiving, including myself. And it's really not to pitch the parents against us. Because, you know, when we become parents, we make our own mistakes. However, it is about knowing that every life is a journey of meeting the imperfect and making ourselves perfect. That is what the journey is. And opening ourselves to that journey. So,
you know what's really interesting always about you? You give like very, sounds like a very simple exercise. But it is not at all a simple exercise. It is like you could take that exercise and if you do it truly with yourself and you start going through it, it can nichodo the emotions out of you. Now, all our viewers right now, if you take this seriously, do this. Because next episode, mein jab hum aur deeper jayenge into this and into other aspects, it'll actually help you. And of course, if you want to reach out and if you experience something, you can definitely reach out to Doctor herself. Correct me if I'm wrong, it's thecenterofme.com, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. And you can mail it to her over there. You can contact her as well. And if you feel like commenting here, of course, feel free to comment here. And any questions that we can take, we'll absolutely try and take them in the next episode as well. If you want to be private about it, then you can message us, DM us the questions. But today, thank you so much, Dr. Rachna Patni, for today's first session of this month of self-love. Because I'm done. I'm done now with all this love shove. Ab mujhe sirf self-love pe dhyan dena hai. So thank you. Thank you for being my partner in crime for this.
So I really wish everyone a February where they invest in loving themselves as a way of loving the world. Because when we can love ourselves, then we can truly love another and we can truly love every other.
So I'm going to open my arms and give a big hug to the world right now.